Well, Adam, we continue to track Tropical Storm Florence this morning. Catastrophic inland flooding continues as Tropical Storm Florence is battering the Carolinas with nearly nonstop rainfall. Though Florence has been downgraded to a tropical storm after making landfall as a Category 2 hurricane, the large system is barely moving over the Carolinas and could dump 2 to 3 feet of rainfall total before it's all said and done. Power outages are reaching into the millions as hundreds have been rescued by those rising waters. Flash flood emergencies in effect. People are having to evacuate their homes. We know of at least 5 deaths that are now being attributed to Tropical Storm Florence. A very dire situation as power is going out there over portions of North Carolina. The latest from the National Hurricane Center, maximum sustained winds at 50 miles an hour, gusting to 65, moving west at 5 miles an hour, west southwest at 5 miles an hour, only about 35 miles west of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. The bands of Florence continuing to come onshore here into a good portion of North Carolina and extreme northeastern South Carolina. New tornado watch this morning, so more embedded tornadoes coming in these outer bands as we get that slow west-southwesterly track in through the majority of South Carolina as we head throughout the weekend. Tropical storm warnings still in effect for the coastline of North Carolina and South Carolina as the track of Florence continues off to the west, then turning northwest by the time we hit early on Sunday morning. Downgraded to a tropical depression. Winds forecast at around 35 miles an hour. Northwest through South Carolina into portions of Tennessee, still as a tropical depression by Sunday afternoon. Then off to the northeast through Virginia into Kentucky and right into eastern Ohio, heading toward Wheeling, West Virginia by Monday afternoon, Monday evening. And that's when we are going to start to see some of those effects from Florence in the terms of rainfall. So through the afternoon, futurecast having Florence, that center of low pressure just off to the east of Columbia, South Carolina, those bands out toward Wilmington, North Carolina. This has been a 1-2 punch for them because they had landfall as we worked from Thursday into Friday. And they're still getting those outer bands with gusty winds, heavy rainfall, the catastrophic flooding. As we see that system work off to the north here, Florence giving more rainfall, Tennessee through portions of North Carolina. We're talking Charlotte, Raleigh, seeing 5 to upwards of 10 inches of rainfall. And then we pull it off into portions of Virginia and Kentucky by the time we hit Sunday afternoon and into Sunday evening. That's when we will look for the increase in cloud cover by Sunday afternoon into Sunday evening with that northeast flow coming in. Temperatures a few degrees cooler heading into tomorrow because of that northeast flow, but I really don't think we see the rainfall until late Sunday night in toward Monday morning. This is 11 o'clock Sunday night. We start to get some of those outer bands with those scattered showers. The heaviest of the rain off to the east, but by Monday morning, hold on to that umbrella. We will have those scattered thunderstorms and maybe even those showers going with it as well. Center of low pressure working off toward Charleston, West Virginia. By then, you can see it right around here. Our run of futurecast here putting it in eastern Kentucky by Monday afternoon. So here for the tri-state, still some of those scattered showers. It's not going to be a complete washout, and we're really not going to see a whole lot of rain compared to what they're seeing over in portions of the Carolinas. To go with that, for this morning, new from the National Weather Service, a dense fog advisory is in effect until 10 o'clock for portions of Indiana, Dearborn, Ripley, Franklin, Fayette, and Union counties, as well as Butler County. Tower Cam 2 showing some fog this morning, so reduced visibility is below a quarter of a mile north and west of the metro for the next couple hours. That rainfall for Florence adding up another 10 inches on the way by Tuesday afternoon in Charlotte, 7.5 to almost 8 inches in Myrtle Beach, just about 5 inches in Raleigh, 4.5 inches in Roanoke, 2 inches in Charleston, and this version of futurecast rainfall about 1 inch in Cincinnati, especially off to the east where they could see more rain than some of our western counties as well. Not too bad fear here at home today. The Cincinnati Bearcats versus Alabama A&M, 7 o'clock kick over at Nippert Stadium, temperatures into the low 80s. Dropping into the upper 70s under that partly cloudy sky. It will be more humid today and tomorrow. Again, that rain moves in late Sunday and into Monday thanks to the remnants of Florence. High pressure builds in for Tuesday and Wednesday, warming things up into the mid to upper 80s. More sunshine for Thursday before more widespread showers and thunderstorms move into the tri-state as we head into the end of next week. Don't forget, we've got continuing coverage on Tropical Storm Florence online and on social media, Facebook and Twitter. And don't forget to download the Weather Authority app as well to stay ahead of all the details. Adam and Perry, back to you guys.
All right.